Not too long ago, I came across an old message board thread about old NASCAR rumors. Most of the stuff I saw were just regular things like, this driver was rumored to join this team in 1996, or this developer wanted to build a racetrack in Hawaii in 2003, you know, normal things. Until I came across one that was much darker than any other. One that would have been devastating if true. One user claimed that in April of 2001, a rumor spread around the garage at the beginning of the Fontana race weekend that Bobby Labonte, the then defending Winston Cup Series champion, had passed away. Wanting to know the backstory behind this, I located a source from the Times News in Hendersonville, North Carolina from that time, and the story goes as follows. In the days leading up to the Fontana race, an unnamed radio station in Memphis had received an anonymous tip stating that Bobby Labonte had passed away in either a testing accident or en route to California. There's no consensus on which version the edgy tipster had used. In any case, without doing any sort of checking in with Labonte or his PR guy, a shock jock on the airwaves repeated what he heard on the air. There's no clip of this I can find, but the people in Memphis who happened to be listening to that station at that time were understandably alarmed. Soon, message boards all over the internet were lighting up with the alleged story. By 2001, technology had advanced to the point where you can spread information quickly, just not as quickly as we can now. Even Labonte himself got a call informing him that he was dead, which honestly must have been quite the shock to him. As this was happening Friday morning, Labonte's PR man, Tim Sullivan, was sure it was nonsense. In actuality, Labonte was already in Fontana, and when Sullivan pulled up to the infield coach lot, Labonte's car was sitting outside the motorhome. As the article states, Sullivan didn't knock on the door because it was 7 in the morning, and he felt kinda awkward saying, "I'm just checking to make sure you're not dead." But when Bobby woke up, he quickly found Sullivan as they tried to get the word out that the story was completely ridiculous. There was no Twitter or Instagram for Labonte to make a post in 3 seconds confirming he was still around, so Sullivan had to wade through 150 phone calls all day and tell each one that the story was a complete hoax. Even as the race weekend started and TV provided coverage of practice and qualifying, where Labonte could clearly be seen winning the pole for the race, the rumor continued to rage on. Crazily enough, the article states that this was not the first time Labonte had been involved in a death hoax. The year prior, a rumor spread that he and Dale Earnhardt were in a plane crash. Eerie considering that this was the spring of 2001, the NASCAR world was still on edge after Earnhardt's accident in the Daytona 500. Perhaps it was the same tipster who had started both rumors. But why Labonte? Bobby was and still is a class act, and although early 2001 was the peak of his career, just coming off the Winston Cup title, I can't imagine there being too many Bobby Labonte haters out there. Like I said, everyone in NASCAR was still hurting from the loss of Dale Earnhardt, and if this rumor about Labonte had been true, it would have drawn a clear parallel to 1993, when both Alan Kowicki and Davey Allison passed away after their title battle the previous season. In 2000, Labonte and Earnhardt finished first and second in the standings. Perhaps it was just some clown out there trolling the idiots at the radio station who proved themselves to be pretty gullible by running the story without any fact-checking. The obvious lesson to take away from this story is, don't believe everything you see on the internet, obviously. Even back before social media, blatant lies spread quickly. If you enjoyed this story, consider subscribing and checking out my other videos. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.